बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। वेलकम टू अनदर टॉपिक ऑन ओरेकल एपेक्स, एंड इन दिस वीडियो विल ट्राई टू कवर डिफरेंट वेज ऑफ सेंडिंग ईमेल्स फ्रॉम ओरेकल एपेक्स। आई बिलीव आई जस्ट लेस देन वन आवर लेफ्ट फ्रॉम द करंट ईयर एंड हैप्पी न्यू ईयर 2022। Inshallah, hope this year will be very nice for everyone, for the whole world. Okay, let's proceed with this video. And the topics I will be discussing today in this video are introduction to emails in Oracle Apex. Okay, let me give some details on the emails, because I always try to share the concepts. Technical things you can Google, you know. It's not what I am going to share. It will be the only one I can share, but you can get the quote from the Google. So the purpose is to convey or tell you the concepts. If concepts are clear, there is no issue. Okay, emails in Oracle Apex, right? When we talk about in Oracle Apex, you can use if I'm not wrong, two ways to send emails. One is built-in email facility inside Oracle Apex using apex_mail, and the other one is the existing one utl._smtp, right? Okay, then we will discuss about how to create and use email template, because you can send email like you were sending from the Oracle database by creating your own HTML tags and all those things, and then concatenate into a string and passing that as a parameter to the procedure or function of sending email, right? How to send emails using different ways, we'll discuss. Okay. In Oracle Apex, when you will use Oracle Apex standard way to send emails, it will be sent to a queue, right? So queue, and there will be a schedule for this, and you can, let's say maybe after 5 minutes or 10 minutes, it will take all the emails which were not yet sent, and it will send that email. And please note, Oracle Apex inside there is no emails server or something like that. You will have to link this to any SMTP, like you will might connect this to Exchange server or any other email server, because this Oracle Apex is sort of a client. You will have to connect to an email server, right? So this is one thing you have to keep in mind. So inside Oracle Apex, you can use apex_mail package to send emails, and in using this you can write your own HTML coding or you can use templates. I will show you both of them, and then you can decide which one is good for you, which one you will prefer based on your requirements or your comfort level. Okay, emails using UTL SMTP. I will share with you the code for this, from where you can take, create and send the emails. Whatever the code required, links I will share under the video, but code, if any is there for this video, I will be sharing the link from which will be uploaded at erpstuff.com, which is our Oracle EBS and Oracle Apex community website. Let's proceed, and let me show you inside Oracle Apex. Let me discard that. Okay, here is the Oracle Apex, and first let me show you without template how you will send the email using Apex Mail, right? So I wrote one process, one process, and inside process a PL SQL code. If I'll click it, I will share this code inside that topic. If you want, you can use that. So if you see here, I'm using the same package which is of Apex under, provided by Oracle Apex, which is Apex underscore mail dot send, right? In this, what we are doing, if you see here, we are creating HTML tags using our concatenations, right? So this way, and this is the body and end and all those things, right? Then you will pass this parameter into Apex underscore mail with other parameters to, from, etc. body HTML, right? So here this HTML will be there, and then you have to add the subject over here, right? And then at the end, if you will write this line, Apex underscore mail dot push queue, so it will immediately send the email instead of keeping in the queue for the schedule to run. It will immediately send and will not keep in the queue. But if you will remove it, then it will be queued, and you can, and the process will be running for the scheduler, and it will keep sending the emails. Now it is up to you how you want to send the emails. If it is a campaign and there are so many emails, I think better to prefer the queue one. You will just comment it out like this. Okay, now the next is, this is one way, and the second one is no template UTL SMTP. Okay, when I'm talking UTL, this is the database feature to send emails. I'm sure you will be aware of that. And if I'm not wrong, I will show you, I will share this link as well. You can use Ask Tom's website, where he has written a procedure. If you see here, HTML email, you will have to create this. For this, you need to get permissions of UTL underscore SMTP for sure. And then you can create this procedure, and then you will have to call this procedure the way we are calling Apex underscore mail. I prefer to use Apex underscore mail, but if you want to use this one, I am just showing it over here. So what I did, I'm just not writing that code here. So what you will have to do, all this code will be same, right? So here, let's say for example, if I have created this procedure, so I will use this HTML. If you see here, here you also have the parameters to, from, and all those things are there. So sorry, my mistake. What I will do in that case, I will be calling that procedure here. Yeah, very simple. Else, almost everything is same. Okay, next is using type and template. I think before this type, let me go to the template part, right? I will not go into detail first. First, let us create a template. So for that, what you have to do, you have to go to shared components of your application. So I'm not saving anything. So this is the shared component, as you see here, application. This my application 75605, shared components, right? In the shared components on the right side, other components, you will come to email templates, right? I just created one over here, right? Let me show you first this one. So this is the template here. I just entered this name and static identifier. That's it. Else everything is created by Apex. So all this, this is the header on the top, then this is the body, and footer, you can change the way you want. And this is the plain text, and this one is the code. I will copy this code, sorry, till here, and will paste in my process the way I paste it over there. Okay. Now, a little bit about this template. Okay, if you are not comfortable with the email format output, because this is based on these HTML codes or styles or all those things are there over here, you will create this advanced. By default, it you will be seeing it empty, you have to click this load default HTML, right? Excellent. Now if I take all this code, control C, I will put it into this site w3schools.com. just try yourself. I will remove this code from here, the default one, right? And I will paste that code into this window on the left side and will click on run. What it is showing, it is sort of formatting and passing the parameters in this. So ideally from here, if you see here, you are creating all these separate, right? This is a body, there is a header, all these things, footers, whatever is there, right? So Oracle Apex is taking this into variables and will add over here. See, so here there are styles, there are others, you know, formatting, borders, etc. And it is header, body, and footer. Now, if I take this body, control A, control C, and let me put it here. I will remove this one and control V, right? And now I will say run. This is how your email will look like, the contents, right? So order date, this, that. The variables in the email template will be look like this. So you have to put this sign hash on the both sides, then it will become variable, and this variable you will be passing from your process or PL SQL, right? Okay, now if you see to the template, this is how, okay, this is the subject. Even if you see in the subject, we are passing order number, right? How we are passing, if you see the down, the sample API, this API we will copy in our page and then we will call. So if you see here, when we'll pass, we will pass values over here, and these are the variables. So order number, whatever will be here, it will print or show in the order number variable, or in wherever we put it, this variable in our email, right? And this template static ID, this is our static ID which we named it at the top, this one, identifier, this one. In the template name, you can't put underscore or any other character, space is acceptable, but here you have to put underscore, so no space. Okay, so now the question is how to create this. I mean, I haven't written anything over here, by the way, except name. So let us try, and I will show you how to generate these templates, right? Okay, then you can change the way you want. We will go with standard. This is just blank. If you see here, there's no code down, right? Nothing, even API is empty, nothing. Okay, I will type a name, let's say XX underscore orders, right? Oh, sorry, I can't put this underscore in the name. But if you see in the static identifier, it is automatically putting over there. Now, rest, let me keep it blank. I will not do anything. If you see here on the right, sample templates, there are three sample templates. Each one is having different formats or purpose or style. So you can try, I mean, which one you would like to have. Different ways of maybe tables, but let's try with the load orders details. I just put it the name and nothing else. Load order details. Okay, automatically subject came here. I can change, no problem. Even the full subject I can pass from the API. Yeah, okay, this everything is written or created for you. The only thing, this is plain text. If your email is shown as a plain text, it will be this in this format, and HTML will be like this, which I just showed you there in the W3 schools. Okay, now what I will have to do, I will save this and will take this one. If any new parameter I need or I want to remove or whatever, what I will have to do, let's say for example this order number is here on the top, it is used there, so I need to pass from the API, right? Because it is used here. Otherwise in the body, if let's say for example I want to change anything, I will be adding it over here or removing it here. Let's say I will copy this one, this table row and table header. So this is order number and table data is down, order number field. I will just copy, just to show you how you can change, Control V, right? Now this is not standard, came from Oracle Apex. I'm just changing it, right? XX column, right? And I will put it XX number, for example, right? And when I will move down, you will see it should be there. It is again formatted, created. If you see here, it came here, right? Or if I want to remove, I can remove. Let's say for example shipping address line 2, I don't need it, right? What I will do, I will come here in this body and shipping address, see here, I can remove from here. If I will remove, it will be removed from the parameters as well. So I will do like this. BR in HTML is next line, like enter. Okay, I have just removed it and let me go down. See, still it will be there, but when I will click down, it will be refreshed. And now address line 2 is removed, right? Okay, let us see the quick one. This is the same format I showed you, the tables, but let me copy it here. Control it. Okay, it is like this, right? It will show, look like this. So let me click this event reminder. I have just clicked it. Everything got changed. It is refreshed with this code and it will look like this. Very simple. Event reminder, and that's it. Again same table and with the values. And let me click the scheduled outage. Okay, that's it. So here it will look like this. Here there is no much table or columns, but it is straightforward email with certain parameters passed to this. And now when you will be preparing and writing an application where you need notifications for approvals, for rejection, you can play with these templates, or maybe you can create multiple templates for or order confirmation or things like that. So you can put it over here. You will have to copy this code as it is, sample API usage, copy, and you will be typing this. I'm just canceling it because it's don't need it. I have this one, so we can play with this. Okay, let me go back and I will be clicking. I just typed in my page email test. Yeah, so same code, template email, I paste it over here. Now since it's a PL SQL, I will be passing the values over here, but you have to pass this apex underscore json dot string stringify, right? Don't remove this. You have to type or give your variables over here, right? So if you have a page item, you can even include that one. Let me see if it is there. No, let me create one page item. Let's say this new one. Okay, copy, and in this template, sorry for a bit lengthy, but this topic is really critical. Where it is writing, right? And now this it will be passed, right? So if you don't want to pass, you can remove from here. So let's say for example if I don't want to pass, but these variables will be there, so they will not show any value. So even I can remove like this, so there is no problem. Okay, now the link, let's say for example you are sending a document for the approval or review or whatever, and you want user to click and that page or whatever application will open, and it will query that record as well. So you can even create your URL and send that URL in the email, right? So now if you will just compile, this will not work because these are not strings. So what I will do, I just want to send some value as it is. So I am making them as a string, otherwise it will give error. Okay, good. I think we are going well so far. So the page URL, now I have to put a page number. Let's say my page number is 1. So it will send an URL with the page number 1. Okay, that's it. Now if you see here, I'm giving over here the HTML. My code is very simple, clean, not messy. But in other case where I have to write all the HTML tags over here, it is bit tough or congested and things. It is up to you. Okay, this is one. Now if you see here, I'm saying using type. Now since we have the template, one way that I can create this process. Other is, I will just create a process and I will come here, I will select the type send email, right? And then if you see here, from this is the setting Apex app email, which will be configured in your in the admin part from email, and this is to then reply to, if you want to give email template. So here you will be select, you can select email template. If in your version it is not available, then please check your version. You need to upgrade, might be. Mine version is on Oracle apex.oracle.com. It is 21.2.0, right? So keep in mind. Then you can come down, and after selecting the template, it will now give you placeholder values which were there, the variables. Now here you can assign the values, or you can select the page item, up to you, like this, right? See, it will pass from the page item. Same way you can even enter your constant values if it is there, or anyway, right? And then if you want to override the language, default language, you can put it over here. I never tried. So here is the language, you can click here. Always try, click any property and click this help. It will give you the details, very easy way. Okay, and I think this should work. If still any query is there, please let me know in the comments under the video. Okay, the code I will share in erpstuff.com over here in the Apex, Oracle Apex. Here, I will share the link for this. And even you can browse some other topics, maybe codes or things like that are available here. You can take that one as well. Quick reference, you can say, yeah, quick reference, because sometimes you forget how to do that one. So instead of struggling, just come and you can take this from here. HTML coding you can do here, you can see here, you want to remove, you want to add, up to you, right? So this is how you can play with your codes. So once you will click the button, it will send the email. So I just clicked one email button, then I will come here in the process. So let's say that one, I will just come down, I will say when button pressed, so I will say email. So it will submit page and will execute this process if the button pressed was email. If any other button process, this process will not execute, right? Okay, good. Right, sir. Thank you very much. And Allah Hafiz. Try to use them. Different methods. Explore the way you want or your requirements. But in the nutshell, this is how you can send the emails. Thank you and Allah Hafiz.